obviously my mind went where it's not supposed to go. Like, oh, it's that kind of
demon. I'm sure there are lots of happy endings in demon erotic. We should save this for our life.
Of course, there is a lot of that's the whole point. Only happy endings.
We are live.
Oh, hello.
Wait just one second.
Are we? Okay, I think we are.
We are live. Hello, everybody. Hi. Hi. It's me, your friend Anuya. And that other girl is also there. Other girls say hi.
Sharon Pizza. That's my new name.
I'm giving us a thumbnail, Sharon. Please talk while I give us a thumbnail. Hello? Oh no, we've lost her, haven't we?
Who lost who? Me?
Ha, huh, I'm saying I'm giving us a thumbnail.
Till then, so I'm posing.
Oh no, it's ready, you silly girl.
Oh no, oh no.
Yeah, I'm just uploading it.
Listen, I was reading this book and then I finished it while getting my hair done and sorry.
What? Okay, I'm going to do this again. Hi, everybody. My name is Anuya. Welcome to the Books on Toast channel. Sharon and I are doing a live after a really long time, and we are very, 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 very excited to be doing it. And we thought that instead of just doing like a random live and an AMA, what we could do is we could also discuss books with happy endings. Yeah.
Yes, so happy endings are the best kind of endings. Only endings we want these days are happy.
Correct. We are happy with all happy endings. Every form of a happy ending.
Yes. We're cool.
Yep. Okay. So should we start then? Sharon, how have you been? Let's do some life updates for our friends.
Oh, okay. I was in Chandigarh for most part of last year. Spent the longest time in Chandigarh after I left that city. Back in the day, 15 years ago, when Kindle was still very expensive and had only one version. It has been interesting coming back to Bombay after 8 months. And I just came back and I'm still getting used to it, hence the blurry background. I also went and got my hair colored today and cut, and I believe that Maharashtra might go into a lockdown, so I'm glad I got some time out.
Aren't you worried about people going that close to you?
No, so I put two masks and I wore gloves and I sat and I didn't drink any water. I didn't take a pee break. I was frozen to the chair and very tormented, but I was like, I will do this because beauty and vanity above safety. Wrong advice.
I'm going to go for my haircut after my second vaccine, not before that.
Yeah, I need your advice on how to get vaccine appointment here.
Oh, I'll do it for you. I'll do it.
Thanks.
Give me your and Sudeep's Aadhaar card. I'm like a vaccine fairy.
Oh, brilliant. Oh, my God.
I'll go to CBD Velapur and go to Apollo and do, but it's not so far and it's a really nice hospital. So,
no, oh, nice.
No, yeah.
Maybe we can make a date out of it.
Yeah, I won't come. Huh? You and he do date things.
Very smart. I was checking you. I knew it.
Okay. So guys, we are 1000% going to be reading your comments and answering your questions. So
yeah, please leave us some.
Yeah, please leave. And also please share your happy endings, books with happy ending,
books with happy
suggestions.
Ending.
Yeah.
Oh, hello. I'm seeing some comments now. Hi, yeah. Sandeep. Hi, Ranjit. Hi, Piyush. Hi, Jane yeah. James.
We are not dead. We are alive. We are just, we were kind of bored and demotivated, but we are back now. We are doing a video every week. So, and we'll be doing a lot more lives. So be sure to catch us. Yeah. All right. So Sharon, who is your, I will be happy to be moderator in this chat. If you can make me one, what's a moderator? I don't think enough people will be here for you to moderate, although that's a really nice request. I think next time when we have 100,000 subs, maybe we'll do let's do a moderator. So let's start. If you guys have any questions or have any comments, please leave them in the comment section. Sharon, do you want to go first with your book that has a happy ending, or would you like me to start?
Why don't you start?
Okay, awesome. This live is my happy ending to this year. Thanks, Kanal. Kanal, am I saying your name right? If not, please correct me. Thank you. So the first book that I'm going to discuss is called The Flat Chair. I've made it my background. See, why does your finger disappear? It's so weird. So I feel like I'm in a science fiction movie. Anyway, so the first book is called Flat Chair by an author named Beth O'Leary. Now, I read this, of course, when I was trying to get out of my reading slump. I have a disclaimer. All three of my books are romances, although each one is unique in its own way. This one is the first, the only out and out sort of romance that I have, but it's not like a schmaltzy romance. It's a nice romance. There are lots of sweet moments, and you root for the couple, even though you hate them just a little bit. But anyway, let me tell you what it's about. It's about a girl named Tiffy and a boy named Leon.
And
Tiffy. Tiffy, yeah, it's Tiffany.
Oh, Tiffy. Yeah. Oh, okay.
And she's very insecure about her looks, even though in my head she looks like Jessica Chastain. So I don't know what her problem is. But anyway, yeah. So she is in this toxic relationship with a boy named Justin, who kicks her out of her house. Of his
Tiffy
house.
And Justin.
Tiffy and Justin, yeah. And then then she has to move out and she doesn't have much money. So because she works in this publishing house that publishes books specialized in arts and crafts. So her favorite client is this woman who does crochet. No, what is it? No, that there's a big, huge trend right now of those.
Calligraphy?
More in knitting things, yaar.
Needlework?
Arey, yeah, whatever, anyway.
Needlework.
You know, now there's those off-white hanging things that hang. Ah, why is the word not coming to me?
Dream catcher?
Yeah, but what is it made out of?
Crochet?
No, not crochet. Anyway, it's like crochet.
Jute? Crochet. People, if you know what she's talking about, please tell her. I'm not into Instagram trends. Oh, hi, Kashin.
Anyway, so that she does that. Anyway, so she works for this company that publishes books on crafts. And what she does is she gets into a flat share situation with this guy who works as a night nurse in a nursing home. So he's not there all night. So the apartment is hers from 6 to 9 and his from 9 to 6. That's the agreement. So they sleep in the same bed, but never at the same time. And then they start talking to each other by leaving these notes to each other. And then that's how, you know, how these things happen, Sharon. Lunchbox.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. So then they fall in love, maybe. I don't know. I don't know if they fall in love. I can't tell you. It'll be a spoiler for a romance. Will they? Won't they? Who knows?
It sounds like the plot of that Hugh Jackman movie.
Which?
You know, I can't remember the name of the movie, but the main character in the movie, like a girl in the movie, she's obsessed with breakups and she's broken up with somebody and she finds some philosopher and while she's mourning the loss of that relationship, she's living with this super hot guy who's a flatmate, Hugh Jackman.
Kate and Leopold.
Huh? No, not Kate and Leopold, though, involves time travel.
Time travel, yeah.
Aray, this used to come 20,000 times on Star Movie. So I used to watch it and I'm like, oh my God, I want to move to Bombay and, you know, share my flat with a guy like this.
And Hugh Jackman. In Bombay.
Yeah, you know, a girl can dream.
Okay, anyway. This, my book, Beth O'Leary's The Flat Chair, is book number one. And it has a happy ending. Iman, this book will help you get out of the reading slump. It's not going to change your life. It's not going to make you think. It is just comfort food, okay? It is just a book you're reading to pass time, to forget everything, and to be happy. So that's the book I recommend. Okay, now you go, Sharon.
Okay, I want to recommend a book that actually a friend of mine recommended to me on this channel. We did a video with him, Akash Khurana. He's a filmmaker. And he had recommended this book to me 20,000 times. Of course, I never read it. And then I read it now. And I'm like, oh my God, yeah, I meko pehle padhni chahiye thi. It's called The Little Coffee House in Kabul. Little Coffee Shop in Kabul. It's by this author called Deborah Rodriguez. And she has written a memoir also on the Kabul Beauty School. She's basically, she used to run a salon and she had worked in Kabul for 5 years, I think, training girls in a salon. So she wrote a memoir about it. And then this is her first work of fiction. And this book has three more sequels after it. Okay.
Wow.
So what is a sequel to a second book? Another sequel and another sequel?
Prequel.
Fourquel. They're quadruples. So anyway.
It's like
Quadratic
equation.
Quadratic equation, yes. It's a series of like really fun four novels, and basically it's a story of this girl, 38-year-old girl called Sunny, who has left her life in America and come to Kabul and started a coffee shop. And then she meets all these like, you know, drifters and travelers who are coming in and out of the coffee shop, and they form a relationship. There's a guy who wants to start a new life, and it's very theatrical. It feels like you're watching a play, and of course Akash liked it because it has that play-like quality in it. But it's there is some little drama that happens, this little romance that erupts in one corner, and it's exactly like what you would think. This is why we go to coffee shops, right? You just like to be in an environment where you can just chill, talk to strangers, maybe eavesdrop a little bit, or just, you know, sit in a corner and cutely eat your food and like just, you know, be there. It's just a very stilling book, and of course it has a happy ending, which is why there's a sequel and another third book and another fourth book. It's just really charming set of four books to read. I've only read the first one, and the second one is called The Return to the Kabul Coffee Shop, and so I'm going to read that next. So I'll tell you if that has a happy ending or not, but this one definitely does. Yes. Anuya, you go ahead with your next recommendation.
I will. I'm just admiring how shiny my hair is right now. So
yeah.
I'm completely distracted. Okay, there is no way I can do a books with happy endings video and not recommend a Sophie Kinsella novel.
Of course.
Sharon was like, let me guess, you're going to recommend a Sophie Kinsella. I was like, duh. What else is there in the world? As everybody knows, I love Sophie Kinsella. Wow, there are some fun questions. We'll come to them. So
guys, please keep putting your questions. We'll come to them at the end of the recommendations that we give out.
Yeah, and also recommend your own favorite books with happy endings that we know what to read next. Okay, like we can't keep recommending books. This has to be a give and take, friends. Okay, now that I've established that, the book that I am going to talk
how
about.
Are you doing this fancy thing?
Arey, you can just go to your backgrounds and add. There's a little plus sign. You can,
I will look for my second book ka background. But anyway, you talk about
this. Go for it. Yes. So, this book is called, it's Sophie Kinsella's latest book. And it's called Love Your Life. Now, that's a really lame name. So, literally don't watch the book by its name. There is much more to this book. Apart from the name. So it's about this boy and girl. Now, what the fuck are their names? I completely forgot what their names are, friends. So their names are Ava and Matt. Okay, so they meet during this writer's retreat. And they sort of start, it's like one of those like burn hot romances, you know, where, they meet in like this Greece or something, or Italy, or one of those like quaint European town, and it's a writer's retreat, and they fall in love, and it's like fireworks and sparks and like great sex, and she's like, yay, I've met the man I want to be with. And within like a few days of being with each other, they decide to be girlfriend boyfriend and take this relationship to the next level. And then of course life comes calling. Okay, they come back to London and they realize that they have very little in common. Like his tastes are different, his friends are strange, and they don't get along with her friends, and blah 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 blah. And slowly they realize that it's not just about the people that they were in that writer's retreat, it's about the people that they are in real life in London. And then they have to figure out how to make things work and sort of really get to know each other all over again. So basically it's Greece, because the holiday romance and real life romance, and how they, maybe they work things out, maybe they don't, who knows. But what I love about this book is, it's of course it's very, very funny. It's hilarious. You'll laugh till you cry. It's that funny. And then of course there are moments of like emotion, like that Sophie Kinsella does really well. And in her last book, I don't remember the name of that, Fix It, Fixie, whatever, that last book, she really messed up in the sense that she finally fixed you. Huh? She finally created a character that I hated, like a girl character that I just didn't like. But she really, she fixes that in this book. And I think this book is the quintessential pandemic read. Like, it has form fuzzies, it has lots of humor, and it has a couple that you really root for. And of course, there's a happy ending, or we wouldn't be discussing this right now. So yeah, book number two is Love Your Life by Sophie Kinsella. Now go share.
Sounds like a fun book. I think I'll pick it up after this live. I'll pick it up next. So thanks.
Oh God, yes, it is, and you'll finish it in like 5 minutes. You know, it's one of those where you'll spend
best. Yeah,
khatam, and you're just like, I'm so happy right now, and that's good. That's good. You don't want a book that makes you think or makes you cry, or I just don't want any of that. I just be like,
Yeah. Oh. Okay, cool. So so the book I want to talk about is this book behind me called The Midnight Library. Midnight Library by Matt Haig. And this also answers Kashin's question. Kashin put a very interesting question there. What's tum dono ka take on people who get their happy endings by deliberately reading tragedies and getting kicks out of it? So Kashin, this is a bittersweet book because it is born out of a tragedy. This book won Goodreads ka Reader's Choice Awards of 2020, and it's basically the story of this girl who commits suicide, but she is not dead. She enters this lacuna, which is basically like a library of sorts, which in which she's reading books that are living, in which she's able to live out all the choices that she regrets making in life when she was, or she, we think she was alive. Okay, so we don't know what happens in the end because I'm not going to tell you. I know, but you don't. If you're not. But essentially what she does is she lives out all the things that she regrets doing, right? Like, she wanted to marry a guy and she thinks what that life is going to be like, or, you know, if she had taken that job, what it would be like. And if she had lived in this place, what it would be like. And she tries to live out those life situations by reading those books based on her life in this make-believe library. And there's a librarian who's also guiding her journey. In many ways, it's very Dickensian. It's almost like the Christmas Carol where, you know, this person goes to sleep and then, you know, he lives past, present, future. But in this case, she's living out her life as she would have liked it to, because she's filled with so much regret. And the endings of all these books happen to be the same ending that happened to her in real life while she was alive. And so, you know, you feel like, you feel many emotions, and that's how Matt Haig writes, right? Like, he's written, what are the other books he's written that we have read because of Shiny Happy Book Club?
Reasons to Stay Alive.
Reasons to Stay Alive and How to Stop Time, right? So he deals with a lot of, all his books are based on themes of mental health, depression, anxiety, suicidal tendencies. This book is also a culmination of many of them. And the reader in this case being you are led to be the protagonist. It's the way he writes. So you feel like all the things that the protagonist is going through, you are going through as well. So in a way, it's kind of an exorcism of all your mental anxieties while you read the story of a stranger. And this book has a happy ending. I'm not going to tell you. I'm not going to fill you with false hope and tell you that the happy ending you envision this character to be is going to happen. But maybe it does, maybe it doesn't. But it really leaves you feeling satisfied at the end. And it's not heavy at all. You know, a book like this can easily become really like dark and troubling and cathartic. None of that. It's like charmingly pleasant, is, even though it's a dark subject. So yeah, I feel like you guys might enjoy it.
Yeah, I read
rubbing this pizza on our heads.
It's a pizza hat.
Yeah,
Pizza Hut ke bahar kya milta hai? Pizza Hut. I'm a little hungry, so I'm like,
yeah, might as well eat your hair.
Yeah, I read Midnight Library earlier this year. I agreed with you. Yeah, I thought it was a very hopeful book. It had, I think all of us who are constantly questioning who we are right now, did we make all the right choices? What are we, is there a path that we need to take in life? Are we, what are we doing? Like that entire existential cloud that hangs over our lives right now, right? In our mid-30s, I feel like for us, Midnight Library is a very good book because it tells us that no matter what, ultimately there is, you are where you're supposed to be and there is always. Yeah. And every choice could have led to something good, yes, but also could have led to something bad or nothing at all. And, you know, so it really doesn't matter, basically. You should do. I read Midnight Library and Dark Matter at the same time, and I felt like both of them had the same sort of subject matter, which is what if I had taken a different path down life? Although Dark Matter is like science fiction, and it's about a man who discovers how to travel within different timelines of his own life. So the whole premise is that if I choose to eat pizza, then there is another timeline, which is eating Chinese food, in which I ate Chinese food, which is slightly different from basically the multiverse theory, right? So it's a man who figures out how to jump between his own multiverses of his own life. And what if he hadn't married his wife? And so he does that, and another version of him from another lifetime comes and kidnaps this guy. So it's very convoluted, but it's a thriller. And it's called Dark Matter. Yeah. Okay. And I felt like both these books sort of dealt with the same subject matter. It was interesting to see how differently they treated them. But yeah, Midnight Library is the nice, warm, hopeful version. And Dark Matter is like, oh, yeah, thrilling things. Based on both are nice books that will get you out of your reading slump.
Definitely.
Yeah.
What's your next happy book?
My next happy book is this book I read in 2 days that I bought day before. As soon as I found it was there, I'm like, shit, stopping everything else and reading this. Because it's an author that both Sharon and I like. Her name is Nicola Yoon. We have spoken about her books. Spoken about her books, Everything, and Sun is Also a Star. Both fun books. She's written a brand new book. It's called Instructions for Dancing. Is it her best book? No. Is it the best book I have ever read? No. But once again, we're talking about books that are heartwarming and that don't take a lot out of you. Like reading them is very easy and there is a happy-ish ending. So that's why I will recommend Instructions for Dancing. It's a Ek Din Mein Khatam Ho Jayega kind of young adult romance book. And it's about this girl who her parents are getting a divorce and she catches her father cheating on her mother. So kind of like it's an event that traumatizes her and she stops believing in romance. So she sells all her romance books. Of course, as a 30-year-old, I am too much of a cynic. I got very irritated. I'm like, ye kya hai? Stop believing in romance. Like, what nonsense is this? Only a child will think of life in such extremes, right? But I feel like I'm getting a little too old for YA now. You know, I've realized that.
Anoya, is there such an age?
Yeah, there is. Some YA is really good, but these puppy love places just don't work for me. I like romances where the protagonists are late 20s, early 30s, trying to figure out life, but I can't read YA anymore. But
so tell me, like, if we read like a YA type romance where the protagonist is in her late 30s, what would that be?
Arey, YA is young adult, na, so the protagonist can't be in late 30s.
Yeah, but what if, like, you know, the tone of the novel is YA even without, like, knowing the age of the
character. That is, like, love your life types. That is that. No, I mean, like, nobody now, you see when a book is written for an older audience, there is a certain amount of realism in the love also.
Yeah, I don't like that, you know. We should stay true to our roots. If it is all like fun and silliness, let's be all fun and silly. No, why is there an age to be fun and silly? I don't understand.
This whole I don't believe in romance novels anymore. I'm like, thappad aarogi chubbet 17 saal ki gandu bahut hai abhi zindagi mein chup lodi aisa mere ko feel aaya par maine padha pura book kyunki kyun nahi itna easy hai and the 18-year-old male character is very sexy. So,
oh, is it?
I was like, wait, what age is he? Okay, 18, I can lust. It's fine now.
Pedophilia, even in reading, okay?
Even in reading, you have to be careful about these things, Baba. Yeah? Very careful.
Yes, I know. Somebody's asking the name of the book. Jasleen is asking the name of the book once again, Anoya. What is it? Instructions for dancing.
Yeah. So she takes all her romance novels and she gives them up to this like free library. And then she meets this lady and has this freaky Friday moment where every time she sees a couple, the lady gives her a blessing or a curse. And every time she sees a couple kiss, she knows how that love story is going to end. So she sees all the key moments in their love story relationship and how it's going to end. So I thought it's an amalgamation of Freaky Friday, of every love story ever, you know, like one of those, like I felt like it was a very average book, but it's good time pass. So that's why I recommend it. The message is nice. And then after that, she gets a book called Instructions for Dancing, and it has the name of a book dance studio. So she goes to that dance studio to meet, her name is Evie, by the way, and she goes to that dance studio and there she meets this boy named X, who's a musician. Like, I felt like all the cliches in the world were colliding in one location, like divorced parents, romance, guitarist, boyfriend. I need a book that I don't have to think in at all, then this is it. You'll finish it in one night. It's very easy popcorn reading. And there's a nice message in the end. Hope, love, blah, 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 blah. Love is all you need. Nonsense. Romance is still alive. All that shit if you want, right? You read this book. It's called... Where's my cover? Yeah, one second. Sub Kindle Pay. The worst thing about Kindle is that you can buy bloody 8 books at a time and read all of them together, just swap between one another. See, it's called Instructions for Dancing by Nicola.
We can see in your background also.
Yeah. So that's the book. That's my third book, friends. And you're like, why are you recommending a book that you so clearly hate? I don't hate it. Guys,
that's how she loves things. She doesn't mean it. She means well, okay.
Yeah, I just don't love it, but you know what? Just let's read books that are trashy for the sake of it also sometimes. Yeah, by the way, I am live adding books and links in the description as we talk about them. So if you click on the description, you will see all the books discussed until now. I'm adding Instructions for Dancing right now. Okay, now Sharon, you go.
Okay, the last book I want to recommend before we should start talking to all of you guys who are leaving such wonderful comments. So keep them coming. Thank you, guys. Hello to everybody. I'm so happy you guys have joined us and, you know, talking to us about books. So the last book I want to recommend is an old one from my youth. It's called Chocolat, with the pretty Juliette Binoche and Johnny Depp, who are on the book cover because it was adapted into a novel, into a movie.
Movie. But we've cancelled Johnny Depp, but that's okay.
No, Johnny Depp is uncancelled. Amber Heard is cancelled.
I think both of them are cancelled.
No, is Johnny Depp cancelled, guys? Please tell us. We don't know. Yeah. It's both hard to keep up.
Sharon, please, I read a lot of celebrity gossip, so...
I thought Amber Heard was totally cancelled because Sharon? She turned out to be an abuser. No?
No, I think they both hate each other. I think that's what the last... Yeah, apparently there was physical violence on both ends. But I mean, of course, there's no way to know because there are giant NDA signs. So who knows what really happened. But anyway, do you know that Bennifer are back?
Really?
They are dating again. They are madly in love. They are all like making out all over like whatever, LA, Bel Air, wherever they live, Miami, some rich, where the rich people live.
Pandemic has turned us all into strange beings. Anyway. I guess she's having like a past moment. Both of them are having a past moment.
Happy and the kids are all happy and apparently it might work out. Yeah, who knows? But
they're living their what ifs in present.
Viva love. So, you know.
Viva love it is.
Viva love between celebrities. Now you talk.
Oh gosh. Okay. So coming to Chocolat, it's a fantastic book by Joanne Harris. Joanne Harris has written a series of some exceptional novels in which food is the major theme. So here are the ingredients for most Joanne Harris novels, especially like Chocolat and Five Quarters of an Orange. Yes. There is this food. There is south of France or some exotic or Germany, basically any interesting small town in Europe, Western Europe. And stories where women characters play critical roles. There is some level of magical realism also happening. And Chocolat is basically a culmination of all these ingredients turned into a beautiful, sinful package. And it's a story of this girl called, what's her name? Vivian Rocher? I think I've written her name down because I read it a long time. Vivian Rocher is the name of this woman. She's this character who comes into this small, sleepy, French town during Lent, and she is a gifted chocolatier, and she opens up a chocolate shop, and she has this gift in which she's able to really hear people's problems and give them the perfect solutions they need in forms of chocolate, you know, like either packages of bonbon or just very sinful bites of something. So anybody who's having some issues, so she's like this interesting therapist who comes to town and treats everybody's issues with chocolate. So she faces a lot of backlash from the local priest because it is during Lent when people are supposed to be fasting, and she's come with all these sinful treats for the entire town, and it's a bit of like the people of the town have like a very spiritual awakening, a sensual awakening, and of course Vivian Rocher finally finds roots after traveling for many, many years. So it's just such a joyful read, and it's because we can't go anywhere, we are sitting in our, you know, bedrooms with walls of chocolate behind us. It's just, it's really transportive. I would recommend not watching the movie and actually reading the book, because the way the French town is described is gorgeous. The way chocolate is described is gorgeous. You can totally, like, you know, binge eat a lot of chocolate while reading this book. It's really worth it. It's just such, there's a lot of romance, there's a lot of heat, there's a lot of spice, there's a lot of sweetness. It's just, I mean, you just be like, please let me become fat and eat all this amazing stuff.
I already have done this program, so I don't need this book. I loved it. I also read it when everybody was reading it. Tabhi maine bhi padha. Achha tha, bahut achha tha. In that, I remember that the child's name, I
has
remember.
A character.
Ha, and she has an imaginary friend.
Yeah.
I remember both those things. Her child's name was Anouk. Imaginary friend was like some patapoof or something. I don't remember. Futufu, tufufu. I think that's all a French. So, but yeah, that it was a very nice book.
Yeah, it's a fabulous book. So yeah.
Heartwarming.
My mom has arrived in the comment section and is calling me Madhuri Dixit. Like, mama, seriously.
Everybody say, mom, hi, auntie. I remember once auntie was like, brush your hair, Anuya, before the shoot. Then I brushed my hair before shoots, guys. I was like, wow, she's right. Why am I not doing such a basic, how lazy a person am I? Stop it, Anuya. Like, comb your hair. I have comb right here.
Oh my God. My mom arrives in the comment section and so does your comb come out. Hilarious.
Chalo, let's do the comments. Ranjit, we answered your question. We're not dead and we're going to be better now. And Sharon, I don't know if you noticed, we now have 47,000 subs.
Oh my God, thank you guys. We've been stuck on 45,000 for about 2 years.
That's because we don't upload. It's our fault. Okay, so yeah.
But thank you for sharing love. If you're new to our channel, you should know we talk about books, and you can see many of our old videos in which we have really celebrated a lot of genres of books. We have talked about sci-fi, fantasy, romance, LGBTQ.
Books to movies.
Yes.
Books, science fiction, historical nonfiction. Lots
of
lot.
Karoor. He's the genre of his own.
He's a genre of his own. My God. Yes, he is.
Yes. Yeah.
So yes, we have that, we do. Then hello everybody, hello. Someone said both of you have such pretty hair. Thanks, Sandeep.
Thanks, guys. I just got mine done today for the Zoom, you know, because it was my social. This is my social life, so I'm really happy to be here. Just
I had a bath for you guys, so you're welcome. Though I was it was like, let it be. What is the point in life and all that? So, but I decided to change myself for this. Lots of people saying hello and hope you're doing well. Yes, as you can see, we're doing much better. Sharon is finally back in Bombay. I'll go see her after I get my second jab, and maybe after she gets the second jab, so not for a long time.
I got COVID shield. I have some waiting to do.
Yeah, so she has COVID, so maybe I'll see her after my second jab because she has antibodies. So Iman, I started reading fiction after watching you guys. Before meeting you guys, I used to hate fiction. Well, yay, I'm very happy that you started reading fiction after, because of us.
Tell us what books you picked up, Iman. It'll be nice to know.
Yes. Shravan says, any new audiobooks you suggest, Sharon?
I've heard some very serious audiobooks. Also did a video about it recently on books that help you cope with grief and loss. And so I feel like you should see that video and see what audiobooks I recommend in it. Plugging.
Good plug, huh?
Thanks. Good.
Yes, Macrame. Thank you. Yes. So her favorite writer is this woman who does macrame. Anyway, thank you. Now, Sumedh says, you gals are the best. That's my reaction. Nikita,
he said, thank you, Sharon ki mummy, for hijacking my compliment.
What was the
Sharon
compliment?
And Noya's parents have a separate fan base of sorts. So sweet, so cute, guys. If you guys haven't watched it, our very, very popular guest, Prakash Zakadar, came on our channel recently, who also happens to be Anoya's very popular dad, who plays the harmonica and is very, very multi-talented and has lots of opinions, very politically solid as well. And my dad loves his political ideas on social media. So you must follow him. He was on the channel recently with Anoya to talk about Marathi literature. So that's our last video. If you haven't watched it, please do.
Yes.
Also, subtle plug. But yes, it's
okay. No, it's not a question. Someone was like, Dark Matter by Blake Crouch. Yes, Jen James. Yes, Dark Matter by Blake Crouch.
Read Stephen King books, Bhavik. Oh,
God.
Shining,
Sharon, I was
secretary, thinning, thinner. Bhavik asked for must read Stephen King books. So thinner, The Shining, Pet Sematary,
The Stand.
He's also written this book on writing, which is amazing. Anoya has read it, so she recommends it highly. I haven't read it.
It's part his life's story and part like a part memoir and part writing guide. So it's pretty good.
You know, I recently read his son, Joe Hill King, who's also a horror author. He's written this book called Nosferatu, which also got turned into like a TV show. It's quite strange and dark. Very, very like papa, like son. Very inspired by everything that Stephen King has written. And there are a lot of Easter eggs of like Stephen King novel characters in Nosferatu. So it's quite interesting. If you guys want to read it, it's called Nosferatu. And the show is on Amazon Prime.
I was thinking we should do a Stephen King reading video like we did for Gaiman and Rushdie. I want to do a non-horror Stephen King reading recommendations, because as you know, I don't read horror. So I want to do like how to read what is his best non-horror work and how to read it. So all of his fantasy stuff. So I've read Dark Tower, which is his seven book fantasy trilogy, which is a seven book fantasy series. And it is superb, even though the first book is the worst, but second and third and fourth and fifth and all of the others are really good. So you should read that also.
So number one is not always good. Don't come first. Nobody cares. It's not nice.
Yeah. Hello, auntie. Thanks for loving the backgrounds. I'm saying hi to your mom.
She said, I love backgrounds?
Yeah, she said. Achha. Someone said, I started reading nonfiction because of Books on Toast. Well, that's great. That's better you than me. I'm reading nonfiction, but like one book in 6 months. Green Mile is great, yes. Green Mile is
Green great. Mile is fabulous. Yeah. What a book.
Then I've read so much, Why Nothing Is Coming. Then that book, he's written, there is a series of four short stories. I think it's called Four Past Midnight or something like that. That's also really good. I also totally avoid the Mayuri K. I also totally avoided the Suitable Boy show because it just sounded bad. And I'm like, I don't want to ruin the memories of the book. Nikhil Majan says, please bring Neville Shah, Rohan Joshi, Dr. Tharoor once more. What do you say, Sharon?
Why not? Let's do it.
Yeah.
Let's update our reading lists with their latest reads. No?
Yeah.
What do you guys think? Would you like to watch that?
I don't know
if Dr. Tharoor will come, but I feel like Neville and Rohan, we might have a better shot.
Sushant Das is saying, have you guys read Amitav Ghosh's Shadowline, Sharon?
Yes, I have. It's really, really nice. But it's a very complicated book. So I also feel like it's one of his... The thing is now with him, he can either write very, very well as a writer or he can tell a very, very good story as a storyteller. I feel like he struggles with both of them together. And the places he got it super right was, of course, the Sea of Poppies trilogy. And even that Egypt book that I love, In an Antique Land, which is a nonfiction piece of work. Calcutta Chromosome, again, like really good. Gun Island was like, eh. So you have to
I feel like all of these, you know, grand old authors, literary authors, all their latest work is hard to read.
Oh my God, guys, can I talk over? So, you know, I had a review of this book and then I fell ill and then I was like, no, I can't. But Haruki Murakami came up with a collection of short stories that I own a signed copy of. So there are very limited editions of those. And I feel guilty talking about this because, you know, I own like a signed Murakami, you know, which was given to me. So, and it's a collection of short stories, but something has happened to him, guys. It's very sad. None of those stories made any sense. They were, you know what they were like? They were like... you know, I'm having, like, if Haruki Murakami got Wattpad. Okay? And he ended up self-publishing just thought experiments that don't have any story, they don't have any narrative. The endings are just like, what happened? Like, none of it makes sense. And he, as you know, is the master of, you know, talking about human emotions, talks about the human experience very well, like rounds of stories. Beautifully, right? Like, you may not always like the choices the protagonists make, but you always understand why they're doing it. His stories at this, like, this collection was just... you know, and this, I'm telling, maybe it's me. I don't know. Maybe it's me. I'm not maybe arrived. And he's like, I mean, to his credit, he's in his 80s. So I'm sure, like, you know, it's not the same. But, like, I read some... Rushdie's again, and I'm like, what is I'm questioning who I am because I'm not vibing with these authors anymore, and maybe because that literature is dated. The person who read those literature in me is dated, no longer exists, perhaps. But like a lot of these old amazing authors, their contemporary works are really unrelatable, and it's really sad. So try not to read newer works, is all I'm saying.
Amazing
book.
Called Clara and the Sun by Kazuo Ishiguro. And I did not enjoy this book at all, even though I managed to finish it somehow. But that's exactly what I mean. All these like grand old men, right? Their works are no longer, can't read the newer stuff anymore. Just read the old stuff and be happy that they, you have it in your life. Also, like in Murakami's case, though, I feel like he'll be like, and someone will publish it. Wow, Farts by Murakami. Just,
I mean, yeah, I feel like, you know, if you become really
audience now, he's like, main kuch bhi likhega agar tum kharidoge, to ye lo kuch bhi, you know, ye lo, tatti. अब खरीदो.
Maybe maybe that's the real definition of prolific.
Yeah, Pokhrat says I call it the Subhash Ghai syndrome. It'll happen to everyone. Or the Ram Gopal Varma syndrome.
That is accurate. RGV was like legend, and then now, oh my God, he has committed suicide. It seems.
You can't. Yeah. Can you recommend? Could you guys suggest any Japanese authors other than Murakami? Remains of Pokhraj, Remains of the Day is what changed my mind about Ishiguro. I really loved that book, and what a great movie adaptation it has. It's on Netflix if you haven't seen it. Can you guys really? Suggest Japanese authors other than Murakami? I haven't been able to find a Japanese author that I absolutely love.
Yeah, there is one person. I will find the name and tell you shortly.
Yeah, I read Convenience Store Woman lately, and while it was very easy read, and I mean it resonated with me in many ways, because it's sort of like this very, you know, straight faced look at society's mores and what they think is okay and what they think is not okay, and how much we change ourselves and how much conditioning we all receive to fit in. But I mean, I thought it was very like chalega type, nice book, but whatever, don't care enough. But yeah, that was the last Japanese author I read. But yeah, Shishiguro Mayuri. Yes. So you know what the problem with this book is, with Clara and the Sun? It's very similar to Never Let Me Go, which I also hated. So what he does when he writes science fiction is that he leaves the world building to us. Like, he throws us into the world, and then we have to put all the clues together to understand what the world is like. And it's very hard because it's already science fiction. And then he gets very emotional about everything. And I'm sorry, I can't take it. I'm like, oh, don't leave me in the middle of this world without enough information about this world. So yeah, I didn't like.
There's this author called Kigo Higashino. He's written a lot of mysteries, crime mysteries and thrillers.
Snow wala na. She's saying not Murakami and Higashino.
Oh, okay. Then I don't know.
Yeah, we need to read a lot more Japanese literature.
I've read Memoirs of a Geisha, Mayuri as well. But again, like, read it ages ago. That time really liked it. But I guess, like, maybe now I might not like it.
Yeah. A lot of people are saying we should get back Rohan. Okay, I'll ask Rohan. I'll send him all these screenshots and be like, chal aaja. Kya kar raha hai waise bhi aajkal? Bahut sari cheeze, bahut paise kama raha hai, lekin.
Do you guys read fan fiction? 80% of my reading is fan fiction for some reason. Much fun. Sushant, please tell me some nice fan fiction to read. I would like to read. I would like to dip into this universe.
Have
you read much fan fiction? I don't remember if I have. No, na.
I used to read Harry Potter fan fiction, which was really entertaining. You know? Yeah, but apart from that, I never had fun reading fan fiction. Was it Men Without Women, Aishwarya Lohi?
No. Men Without Women is very old collection of short stories, so that's still good. This is, I'll tell you what it's called. Hang on. It's really not worth it, but I'll tell you what it's called.
Someone's asked us for two book recommendations for books that we couldn't stop reading recently. I have very good books, friends. I can't find the question. I just remember reading it. Yes, Breasts and Egg. Yeah, a lot of people are talking about it. I don't know if I should read it. Guys, there are a lot of great Japanese recommendations in our comment section right now. Please go. Kisne poocha yaar, two books that... Okay, I can't find the comment, but I'll give you two books and then Sharon will give you two books.
Two
books that we couldn't stop reading.
Okay.
Yeah, the first one is called I Have Evangelized about this book as much as a human being can. It's called The Push by an author named Ashley Audrain. It's a debut novel that came out this year. It is one of the best books that I've read this year. It's about a mother whose experience of motherhood is not what she thought it would be. And this book is not what you thought it would be. And it is a thriller. And it's absolutely, it's a page turner. You will not be able to put it down at all. Just stop everything and read. And then someone has recommended a book that, please, madam, please read what? One second. Oh my God, you guys, slow down. Madam, please recommend a book for a guy who needs to fall in love with books again. Please read the Century Trilogy by Ken Follett. That's
it. Yeah, it's also very, very big.
It's this big, but you will not even, you'll be like, so who cares? I don't give a fuck. More. Last night, I kid you not, I missed reading Century so much. I have bought the sample to Eye of the Needle, which is his first historical fiction book. It's like a World War II spy thriller. So I have downloaded the sample to that book and I cannot wait to see if I like it. I'm sure I'll like it. But that is how much I love the Century. Me and my friends are a group of Century Trilogy loving people. And Smriti Sant was the one who recommended that to me. So I love you, Smriti. I will be indebted to you forever. But it's his historical fiction about World War I, World War II, and the Cold War. And it is, I mean, to answer books that you will not be able to put down, it's three books. Enjoy. After that, read Pillars of the Earth. And you're sorted for like a month at least.
The Murakami book collection that came out is called First Person Singular. The title should tell you everything.
Wow, Neville. Okay, we'll get Neville. Books you started but couldn't finish reading. Oh my God, so many. Last year, I stopped reading so many books. Sharon, do you remember any books you started but couldn't read?
I mean, I started this yesterday and I thought it will be very nice, but I just abandoned it because it seemed very tropey to me. It's called The Lost Apothecary by Sarah Penner. I mean, premise-wise, it's very interesting. I finished half of it and then I was like, what's the point of reading it further? I know the full story without even finishing it. So what's the point? But yeah, this...
It's not bad.
But a book that I recently picked up that I loved and couldn't stop reading is actually Jhumpa Lahiri's Whereabout. It was supposed to be one of the most awaited books of the year, and I'd wanted to read it for quite some time. And I did finish reading it, and it's spectacular. It's typical Jhumpa Lahiri. It's everything they say. The payoff is amazing, and it's single woman character themed stories just hit a chord with me personally right now. So I'm just really, really enjoying reading those. So I really couldn't put it down. I really wanted to know what is going on. It's like watching a series. You just had to like keep at it. And I was reading it and watching Mayor of Easttown at the same time. I don't know if you guys have watched it. It's just amazing show. So it's similar in terms of characterization of the person, the main protagonist. Not that Whereabout is a mystery at all. It's just drama, literary fiction, but just very, very well written. Amazing. Yeah. Yes, Smriti. Hi, Smriti. Yes, Jhumpa can't go wrong.
Shout out in everything.
Yes.
Guys, I tried reading the book that won the Women's Prize last year. I read almost 50-60% of it and then I gave up. It's called Hamnet.
Yeah, which one?
Hamnet by some Maggie something.
But that's not bad. It's based on Shakespeare's son whom he kind of used to write Hamlet, but you know, was not Hamlet. But you know.
Yeah. It was very boring. I valiantly tried to read it. Like almost 50% I read. And then I couldn't. Then there was this book that Smriti loves called Know My Name by Chanel Miller. It's the survivor of the Stanford sexual assault case. That book also I read 50% and then I gave up, not because it wasn't very well written, but It was relentless. I just couldn't take it. And we were in the middle of lockdown. So that book, and I also started reading When I Hit You by Meena Kandasamy. Incredibly written, beautiful, lovely prose. But the subject matter is so dark and depressing that you can't take it after a while. I couldn't. But I'm going to pick that book up again when after COVID. Please, God, let there be an after COVID when I'm in a better state of mind. And I will read that book because the writing was really good. I think she's very, very
talented. Post-COVID. I feel like that should be a music genre, post-COVID.
I loved Homegoing by Yag Yasi. So I tried reading Transcendental Kingdoms. But again, depression and sad. I don't want to read this. I'd much rather read cliches than just like sad, depressing stories about sad, depressed people. I couldn't. Not now. Maybe later. Okay. I think we should stop. It's been an hour.
It has?
Yeah.
Yes. Wow. Shannon's recommendation of two books you want from me. One is Whereabouts by Jhumpa Lahiri that I finished reading recently that I couldn't put down. Second book, there isn't a second yet, okay? That is not Demon Erotica, so I'm not going to answer this. I have spoken much about Demon Erotica in the last 3 months, more than I would care to admit to myself, but yeah. I've read them many times, okay?
I'll do a second book. I read a book called The Wife Upstairs, which is a Jane Eyre.
Oh, is it good? I picked up two times and then left it. I don't know why.
I read it all night.
With it.
All night I read it. It was amazing. Again, a thriller. So, you know, always fun to read and enjoy. And have either of you read Sense of an Ending? No, you know what? I haven't read Sense of an Ending. I should read it. It's, you know, it's... Yeah, Sant, you know, Sant reads. It really broke me, that book. Everything she describes is amazing, and it's an awakening, you know. It's like everybody should read it and be like, this is what women go through, but this is what we go through constantly. I don't want to read also.
Want to read this depressing book.
Yeah. Too much. Can't read about it. I know all this is my life. Men should read that book. Men, read Know My Name by Chanel Miller. Read it. Okay, chalo. Mujhe bahut bhook lagi hai, friends. So, this pizza hat is also not helping.
Thank you. Thank you, Bharat Balachandran. Thank you very sweetly. He's encouraging us and saying that you guys are doing a great job. I think we need to hear that over and over again. But thank you.
Yeah.
We try, okay? We try. So, here's the thing, guys. We really try to be punctual. And it's not like, you know, we don't want to make content. We want to make content, but we just need to also make money. And both of us have families we are living with. So there's just too much going on. Okay. So we will try to not disappear again, but yeah, no promise.
Yeah. I think Sharon, we should aim for 100,000 subs by the end of this year. It's an achievable.
Guys, can you please make it happen? So finally we can like work less and do this more.
Yeah. But you guys, please subscribe to Smriti's channel, Sant Reads. She reads a lot more and is way more regular and is better at everything than us. Yeah, please subscribe to Sant Reads. I read a lot of books that she recommends. I'm on the last 20 pages of Color Purple. That book has been...
Oh, Color Purple is amazing.
But I only got reminded of it because Smriti did it. So yeah, I look at what Smriti is reading, although she reads a lot of heavy stuff, which I can't tolerate. But definitely subscribe to her channel. And come to me when you want like trash. I'm very good at trash. Yes, I have watched Dark Shravan and loved it. Best TV show ever.
You know, I really wish there's a light after this.
There's a what?
There's a light after dark. Like a light version of dark.
The light version of dark, yeah. Where they are like, hey, it's like the Y version. But they're skipping different timelines.
Skipping in the end.
And it's a happy ending. Yeah. Yeah. They all get together. Everybody is happy and there is no blackmail.
Yes.
Like, just people are like, oh, I forgive you too. Light. It's not funny, dude. Okay. I got to go, friends. I have a deadline also. So let's go see to our real life troubles. This was a lovely break.
Heisenberg White is asking us, when is the next song of Ice and Fire book coming? Well, yeah. Why don't you tell us, Heisenberg White, when is it coming?
Yeah, you are Heisenberg.
I mean, does anybody even care about it anymore? Matlab, honi kya? I think the time of Game of Thrones is over. It's done.
Yeah. I think we should move on now, which is very sad because there was a time when people were getting Game of Thrones tattoos, you know, like, and I bet they're looking Yeah. You know, I have realized one of the greatest lessons in life that I've learned, Sharon, is this. Do not take, pop culture tattoos on your body. Pop culture.
Because you never know when it will get cancelled.
Exactly. Guys, do you know all the authors?
Seriously.
A lot of authors have been cancelled. Please don't mention any of these authors or you will lose followers. Lots of them. Just keep up with literary gossip. Thank you.
Yes, please.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, bye, friends.
Bye. Have you guys. Have a fantastic weekend. If you're reading something over the weekend, please tell us. Please stay. Give us shout outs all the time. We feel encouraged to do more.
Yes. Although we get a lot of really great messages from a lot of you on Instagram.
And yes, so thank you for that.
Help us, like, keep going, and we promise to do a better job. Next live, we'll try and do a live once a month. So we'll put up posts on our YouTube page, on our Instagram, on our Twitter. So whenever we do them, you'll know. Make sure you follow us on Instagram. Mostly it'll be on a Friday. Mostly it'll be like the third Friday of the month where Sharon and I are like, mere ko sujra nahi hai kya video karna hai. What to do now? So that's when we'll do a live. Okay.
And we'll have some podcasts coming out soon as well. So keep, please make sure you subscribe. If you've got the push notification button on.
Yes. Make sure you're on the bell icon. Please make
sure. I feel like a boomer right now.
You are not, but you are a very borderline millennial. Se hum dono.
Push button age.
We are not boomer. We are Gen X and millennial borderline.
You know what we are? We are early millennials called Zennials with an X.
Wow. I can be a Zenny.
I'm a Zennial, okay? Zennia, the warrior princess, but Zennials.
Yeah, oh my god, that is an old reference. That's how you know you're a Zennial. Zena, warrior princess. Who knows Zena? Oh my god, it's like dark is happening into me in life. Okay, bye everybody.
Bye.
Hey, good job reading normal people. Don't watch the show, it is boring as fuck. It's the most boring show in the world. Do not watch it, just read the book. Okay, bye, friends.
Bye. Thanks for watching. Bye.